of people that are in real estate wholesaling right now are doing this self-employed, right? Some of them don't even count how much money they're spending into. And I paid that $3,000. Well, it was first of all a free seminar. You know how that goes, right? A free seminar. And then they upsold us on $200 for like a day. After the one day, then they upsold us on the $3,000. And after the $3,000, they tried to upsell us on something bigger. But of course, I was out of funds. I mean, I was a student. I was finishing my master's degree. So there was no way. I felt the only thing they were upselling us is coaching and mentoring, personal touches. But I was just like, no, that's it. I have enough stuff to follow through. But the one thing that I got out of that training at the time was to join a local real estate association. And that's when I joined. Some of you may even know what that is. It used to be Garden State Real Estate Association. And that's where I met Bob Barenbach, Anthony Cardinale, Glenn Gallucci, Anthony Reeves, Richard Douglas. This is where I met those guys, you know. Within a year, my name was literally all over the place, because if there's a deal, my name is on it, you know, and people knew where I was. And just by working and hustling and making that money, okay? But at the time, it wasn't as popular to be coaching the whole world real estate wholesaling. You see, somebody said marketers destroy everything, and it's true, you know, because the truth of the matter is that what we do is we trade attention, right? So you have to be aware of that. You have to be aware that everything is evolving. At the end of the day, as a business person, you're looking for attention. You're looking for people to come into the store. You're looking for people to start checking out houses through you. Or you're looking for people to call you so you can buy their houses. That's wholesaling, right? So what is, first of all, before I go any further, some of you may be here. Maybe you don't know what real estate wholesaling is. It's very simple. You find deals, okay? You find deals. You look at houses, and you're looking for a house that's priced or discounted lower than the value part of the marketplace is saying, right? So we pull up comparable houses to see what the value of a property is. If the value of the property is $100,000, if somebody is willing to give you that property for $65,000 minus the repair cost, then you have a deal, okay? You put that under contract, and now you have what you call a controllable, equitable interest in the property, and you can sell that simple piece of paper for $5,000, $10,000, and somebody will buy that for $10,000 and then pay for the house. So and that means they end up paying about $75,000 or so, right? But it's still a good deal for them. And they put in some work, $5,000-$10,000, and then they flip it for the full price of $100,000, they make profit. So you being in between like that, that's how you make money. Now, the way I did it was I find pre-foreclosures, right? And people are owing more than the house is worth, but I would get them to sign the paperwork, then I would talk to the bank. I was doing short sales. This is what we call short sales. I'll talk to the bank to get the bank to discount how much is owed to the bank. I was doing short sales when realtors had no idea what the hell short sales was. When the market crashed in 2008 and 2009, short sales became popular, right? So when it becomes popular, what, guess what that means? Well, there's too much supply of that situation in the marketplace. Essentially, you're not going to make as much money. There's higher competitions, right? But you can still thrive, but it means you gotta get around the competition somehow, somewhere. You have to hack something, right? And essentially, what I'm going to be sharing with you here today is a hack. Okay, as a matter of fact, it's a seven-figure secret that you can apply to any business. Okay, you could be a realtor, you could be a real estate professional, investor, right? As a matter of fact, some of the best gurus around you are already doing it, but I want to shed some light on it so you can see it, and you can see that you can do it as well. Okay, they've already always done it, you know, but you know, they teach you to just go out and find deals, right? But here's the truth. If you keep spending money on direct mailing, that does not work as much as it used to work. Here's why it doesn't work as much as it used to work. The gurus, the fortune builders, you know the names, right? All the gurus in the world, they're teaching a ton of people to go send mail to pre-foreclosures, okay? a lot more people than it used to be. So now when somebody is in pre-foreclosure, it's public record, right? So you can kind of imagine in your head how many letters are showing up to that person's house, right? So do you have a chance that your own letter will be picked up? Of course. But is the chance a lot less than it used to be back in 2005? Of course. Yes, of course. Okay. So that's why maybe you've been sending letters, you don't see any action, or you send for 5 months before you see any action. You know, that's all money. That's a lot of money that you're putting out there that's not coming back. And then you find yourself in what I call the new rat race. Okay. You're trying to make your first deal, your next deal. You're waiting 3 months, 4 months before you do a deal, right? And you have to wait for a deal to bring in money, right? So the new angle I'm going to give you right now is a cash flow. It's a cash flow a perspective to building the business, okay? First of all, you need to be building an empire. Just focusing on real estate wholesaling is the wrong way to go about this business, okay? It's you owning another job. You might as well just go start a plumbing business and just be the one doing all the work, okay? There's a difference if you understand the four quadrants from the Rich Dad Mastery courses, right? You understand the business, the investor, you understand the employee, and the self-employed, right? A lot of people that are in real estate wholesaling right now are doing the self-employed, right? Some of them don't even count how much money they're spending into the marketplace. Some of them are not even paying attention to how much money they're putting in. And because somebody told them, just keep going, right? And truth is that if you keep going, you're going to nail a deal. And yes, one deal can pay for the next 1 year, right? But here's what I tell people, like, listen, why would you just want to throw money away if you can make a lot more money with the same, if you can get a bigger bang for your buck, why would you want to do that, right? And that's what I'm going to share with you here today. You have to, if you want to thrive in any business, you have to create a hack. You need a hack, okay? If you're thinking like everybody else, if everybody else is doing what you're doing, you're already losing money. Because if you look at the cash you have in your hands, it's already losing value by just it being in your hands. Imagine how much more you'll be losing if you're just doing what everybody else is doing, okay? So I want you to consider yourself lucky for being here if you're listening to this at any time, because the truth is that real estate wholesaling as we knew it, you send letters and then people call you and then you flip the deal, is dead, and it's becoming dead and deader and deader and deader every day. I don't know if that's English word, but it's getting worse every day because the gurus are teaching everybody, their moms and pops, to send mails to those houses, and that's reducing your chances of building a business. Okay, if you have to wait 2, 3, 4, 5 months before you make money, how long are you going to be doing that for? The highest amount of money I've made from one deal, which is nothing compared to a lot of people in the industry, is $82,000. $82,000 is a lot of money. I couldn't breathe for like the whole day because it's weird to have that kind of check in my hand and put it in the bank. Okay, but the truth is that knowing what I know today, it's not a lot of money, especially if another check is not going to show up for the next 2 or 3 months, okay? Because the brain doesn't work like that. The best kind of business you can build has cash flow, okay? I don't care if it's 5 grand per month. I don't care if it's 10 grand per month. I don't care if it's 30 grand per month. But you want to be sure that that money is going to come in every month in and out, okay? If you have that, you are the king. But if all you depend on is flipping real estate or just closing deals before you make that happen, you become a slave to the system. And that's not what you want, okay? The difference between the B quadrant and the S quadrant are systems. Systems, okay? Systems that continue to put money in your pocket, whether you close a deal or not. As a matter of fact, more deals will come in because you have a system. Because part of the job of the system is to attract deals to you. Are we making sense? So that's some of the things I'm going to be sharing with you. You're going to be removing yourself from the S quadrant to the B quadrant. Chances are you're not in the I quadrant. You're not dishing a lot of cash out so it can come back, okay? And plus, the way I'm going to share with you is the lowest possible risk as you can think about when it comes to business, okay? So we're in the digital age. Obviously, everything is changing. Everybody is operating from their phone, right? Everybody's communicating using their phone, text messages. People don't like calls. Plus, it's unproductive to be staying on a call anyway. You're more productive texting messages and, you know, knowing what people want. And then if you have to get on the phone, it needs to be time blocked, right? We're getting more and more awareness about that. Time is becoming more and more valuable than ever before. That means you never have enough of it. And if your speed is slow in business, you're gonna suffer. Your business is gonna suffer. Your kids, your family are gonna suffer because every energy you put into this business is being taken away from other things. It's been taken away from spending time with your family and things like that. All right. So I'm going to be sharing this. So hopefully I gave you a good narrative from where we started. Okay. I went full time, by the way. I went full time in October 2006, and I've never had a job since then. Okay. And that's a good thing. Okay. Because not everybody agrees that's a good thing. I've never had a job, but I've produced more than an average human being. If that makes any sense to you. You see, the money you're going to make, I don't care in what industry, it's going to be directly proportional to the value you bring to the marketplace, okay? The money you're going to make is going to be directly proportional to the money that you bring, sorry, the value you bring to the marketplace. So you ask, Ola, how can I bring value to help me attract more deals, right? Great questions. Fantastic, fantastic question, right? How can I bring value, so much more value than 24 hours allow you to bring in any given day, right? How can you make $1,000 per day, right, without closing a deal first? Let me share another thing with you. If you are waiting, what is easier, if you have money coming in, cash flow, right, it's easier for you to stay in the business until you find your deal, okay? You have room, you have